Hi everyone, my name is Nathalia and my group and I study at the Federal Institute of Santa Catarina in the city of Joinville. And this is our English and History work. Today we are going to talk about the England's most celebrated dramatist and poet known as the England's Bard. The person that I'm talking about is William Shakespeare. Shakespeare was born and raised in a small town called Stratford-upon-Avon in England. He was born in April 23 of the year 1564 and had seven other siblings, all children of Catholic parents. In the history of that time, England had just converted to Protestantism, a fact that had created a big tension between the religions. It is an aspect that would be present in Shakespeare's future works.
There's no record of Shakespeare's schooling, but he likely began his studies at the age of 6 or 7 and he probably attended to grammar school as well. This school highly valued the Greek classics, just like the study of Latin plays and religious education. These factors were very important and present in his works because of the rescue of the classic, in other words, the Renaissance.
From the year 1558 to 1603, the Queen Elizabeth I reigned over England. This period became to be known as the Golden Age of English history, being the peak of the Renaissance in the country. It was a period of large transformations in all social areas. At this time, the Elizabeth Theatre also grew up, and authors such as Shakespeare created plays that broke with the tradition and style that England was used to. The Protestant Reform and Humanism have introduced new elements into these representations. It was through groups of actors of that time that the theatrical professionalism emerged, which is still valued nowadays.
In 1584, William, at the age of 18, married Annie Hathaway, who was 26. They had three children, the oldest is Susanna and the twins Judith and Hammond. The baptism of his three children is William's last record for 7 years. These years are known as Shakespeare Lost Years. At some point, William went to London, leaving his family behind and starting his career as a playwright and actor.
After his lost years, his first record appears, and it was not a good thing. It was a negative criticism of Shakespeare. He was strongly criticized by another playwright, named Robert Greene. He called Shakespeare a rookie raven and named him Shakespeare, literally a scene shaker, and that he was a handyman who pretended skill. Greene criticizes the fact that Shakespeare, unlike Greene, had not studied in college and had no academic mastery, but was still succeeding.
His works consist of 38 pieces, 154 sonnets, two long narrative poems, and several other poems. The best-known pieces are Romeo and Juliet, Hamlet, Richard III, King Lear, Othello, Macbeth, The Merchant of Venice, Julius Caesar, Machado for Nothing, Antony and Cleopatra, and Coriolanus. In these works, he worked three different types of plays. The stories were about the lives of famous kings and figures from history, the comedies that usually end with a marriage, and the tragedies that end with the death of the main character.
William's sonnets explore love, sex, and beauty. Many of them have become one of the best-known poems in all English literature. Two of the most famous are the Sonnet 18, Should I Compare You to a Summer Day, a poem about love, on which several people say that the poem was dedicated to his son Hammond, who died at the age of 11 by a plague. In the sonnet 116, Don't Leave Me with the Marriage of True Minds, which deals with love in its most ideal form, praising the glories of lovers who meet freely and enter in a relationship based on trust and understanding.
The famous play called The Tragedy of Hamlet, Prince of Denmark, tells the story of how Prince Hamlet tries to avenge the death of his father, King Hamlet. Since the beginning of the 17th century, The play has been famous for its ghostly characters and the vivid dramatization of melancholy and insanity. Hamlet is also often regarded as a philosophical character, who exposed the ideas now known as relativists and existentialists. The clearest example of existentialism appears in William's famous monologue, "To be or not to be? That is the question."
To be or not to be? That is the question.
Another very famous scene from the play is when Hamlet looks at his skull and starts questioning himself.
Alas, poor Yorick. I knew him, Horatio.
Romeo and Juliet is a tragedy written about two teenagers whose death ends up uniting their families, once at war. Today, the relationship between Romeo and Juliet is considered to be the archetype of youthful love.
It is my lady. Oh, it is my love.
The tragedy of Julius Caesar is a tragedy that portrays the conspiracy against the Roman dictator Julius Caesar, his murder and its consequences. It is one of several Roman plays he wrote, based on true Roman history.
And I pray for your soul.
He had an incredible influence on the English language and invented hundreds of words that we still use today in the English language. He invented over 1700 words, changing nouns into verbs, turning verbs into adjectives, connecting words never used together before, adding prefixes and suffixes, and creating original words. Here are some of the words first used in Shakespeare writings.
Accused, amazement, bedroom, champion, down, eyeball, fashionable, gloomy, gossip, lonely, majestic, obscene, secure, torture, unreal.
We can see that they are simple words, but they generate enormous wealth and are very important for William's works and for the construction of the modern English.
Shakespeare's plays made him famous and rich. At that time, he was a shareholder in Lord Chamberlain, one of the leading officers of the royal household in the United Kingdom. Together, they created their theater, called Globe. In this image, it is possible to see each room of the theater, with areas destined to the extras, royal crown, and common public.
Although in the year of 1644, the Puritans conquered power and shut down all the theaters because they considered them inadequate, including the Globe, which unfortunately was destroyed 2 years later. But now, fortunately, in 1997, the new Globe Theatre was inaugurated by Queen Elizabeth II, located a few meters from the old one, being designed and built to be similar to the original. Just like the old one, it attracts a large audience, showing us that Shakespeare was and still is a great success.
Shakespeare died on April 23 of the year 1616, the same day as his birthday, when he turned 52 years old. Only 50 years after, a possible cause of his death was disclosed when the vicar of Stratford-upon-Avon claimed that he died of a fever contracted after drinking too much at a party. His body was buried in the same city in the presbytery of the Holy Trinity Church.
Shakespeare's funerary monument, erected by his family on the wall near his tomb, shows William writing. Each year, in celebration of his birth, a new bird feather is placed in his hand. William Shakespeare had an incredible knowledge of human nature explored in his characters. He understood the human soul like no other author ever understood, illustrating and developing the human motivations, defects, and behavior, leaving a mark on the history of the world literature. This ease of communication through words, capable of overcoming any barrier, are true works of art. They remain alive today and are often portrayed in theater, television, movies, songs, and literature. We can affirm that his works will continue to be prestigious to other times, because it is amazing, it is pure, and it is immortal. William Shakespeare is truly immortal.
The rest is silent.